Welcome back to One Startup World, our 2023 summer conference. It is the premier global startup conference dedicated to helping innovative and disruptive startups succeed. It's the perfect platform for startup founders to pitch their ideas, gain valuable insights, connect with other like-minded entrepreneurs, industry experts, potential investors, and potential strategic partners, all learning from the best in the business. So lots of great content so far as part of our conference. And our next segment here is Igor Tesinsky. He is the founder and CEO of Intellibonds, and his discussion is going to be on his company, which is AI in the fixed income world. And he's joining us today from London. So Igor, let me hand it off over to you. Welcome. We look forward to your presentation.
Thank you, Glenn. So as you said, let me introduce you to Intellibonds and let me share my screen. Hopefully everybody can see it soon. We are an AI-augmented SaaS platform that helps institutional investors with investment decisioning process to improve investment returns and then with the cost optimization or cost reduction. The problem we are solving has multiple angles. One of those angles is that many portfolio managers are unable to run complex portfolio optimizations, especially in the insurance space or pension space. And time to process data is extremely long, which often leads to suboptimal investment decisions or risk decisions. And you know, we have seen what can happen if you do not move fast enough on Credit Suisse or businesses alike. Then the second aspect of a problem is within the credit research section, and there many companies ultimately report earnings only once in a quarter. And in between, investors are blind and just second guessing whether everything is all right with the company and whether there is any change in the credit worthiness. And ultimately, Intellibonds is trying to address those problems and have a workflow automation on the top of it. So our products, we have created two of them. One is called Credit Assist and the other one is called Portfolio Assist. Credit Assist is really there to help users with the predictive credit risk analytics and credit worthiness scoring. And in addition to that, we also read the news, predict pricing, and combine multiple algorithms into multi-algorithmic scores, which is helping investors to capture forward-looking return, which currently would not be available or would not be recommended to them without our technology. And then those trade and risk recommendations are consumed in a portfolio assist. And this product really builds or constructs portfolios, rebalances them, and optimizes them based on the interaction between the user and the algorithms. In terms of the market we are targeting, well, we are targeting institutional investors or B2B market. There are approximately 420,000 of those across the globe. And we are targeting around 2% as our obtainable market, which out of the 100 billion spending, it should equal to approximately 1 billion in revenue over time. Our revenue model is a combination of SaaS licenses, which is our core at the moment. And then we are looking at enterprise license SaaS model and also a revenue sharing model, which are currently in the development. Outside of that, we have started to sell our product only recently after almost 2.5 years of R&D in summer 2022. We signed our first client towards the end of 22. And at the moment we have multiple trials, POCs, engagements with most significant engagements currently happening in the insurance segment. And we hope to close second and third client in the next 2 to 3 months. Outside of that, we work with accelerators such as one from Moody's Analytics or the IFC Fintech Hive. I think the Moody's Analytics is particularly important because we are currently in the process of also integrating with Moody's PFAR platform, which will give us access to approximately 2,500 asset owners on the PFAR platform and obviously opens a lot of cross-selling opportunities. But equally, we work with SimCorp, which is another multi-billion business that is providing investment management solutions to asset management and asset owners. And together with them, we also have a partnership. And the first client we signed was also with SimCorp. In terms of what makes our product unique, so there are established players which mostly use quantitative solutions like Bloomberg FactSet and cost a lot. And then there are a couple of the innovative solutions like Bonded Scoreable / IMTC. Where we differ, well, we offer hyper-personalization. We offer alpha generation and backtesting driven by the algorithms. And then we also offer various high level of automation across multiple functions within the organization. So any working silos company may have normally get removed. Moving on into 2023, what we are doing at the moment, well, we are fundraising, as was mentioned earlier on. We are looking to hire head of data science and head of sales in the Q3. And then in terms of the product, we are integrating GPT-4 through our partnership with Microsoft and OpenAI, and we're driving more of a client acquisition through the corporate partnership or otherwise. Our ask currently is 1 million. So the funding is eligible for those based in the UK. The objective is to cover 18 months runway. Mostly we will spend the resources on building distribution channels, but there is about 30% of the resources allocated to product development. And this is GPT-4 integration for assisted report writing, for example, and a couple of other use cases. And then also professional services of trademarks, patents. We're planning to get a couple of those over the next year. And then finally, the team, who we are. So it's myself as a founder. I spent roughly 16 years in the fixed income industry. As analyst and then as assistant portfolio manager, working for either investment banks or investment managers. Then we have Sanjeev. Sanjeev is our head of technology development. He spent roughly 15 years in Morgan Stanley running technology teams. And then on the business development front, we have Madhur and Juliet. Madhur in particular spent roughly 40 years in investment banking before him deciding to go part-time and just helping startups. Outside of that, we also have a very strong advisory board with Stan Beckers and Paul Hatfield being most noticeable. Stan is chairman of Nomura, and Paul Hatfield is a CIO of Alcentra, former CIO of Alcentra Asset Management. So that's us. That's a brief introduction of what Intellibonds is and what our products are. And now, without further ado, let me quickly show you the value add our platform creates. So as I was saying, we have two products, Credit Assist and Portfolio Assist. A client simply uploads the portfolio into the platform. So ABCD is a theoretical portfolio we have uploaded worth almost 400 million. And for that portfolio, client can potentially get the 5.4% return for a 4.8 duration and market risk of 3-1 and a credit risk of AA2. Let's assume that the same client is trying to get for the same level of risk incremental return. So what a client would have to do, he would go to the portfolio setup and he would set various constraints. In this instance, we're trying to maximize risk-weighted returns, so the strategy is maximize yield. But it could be other strategies. And if there is a cash coming in into the fund, you can either insert it here as an inflow or outflow, and then choose your selected benchmark, and then other risk return parameters and the transaction costs. I think what's unique about us is this IB score. And IB score, as I was saying earlier, is a part of a credit assist, and it's a really forward-looking predictive multi-algorithmic scoring. So once the client or the user sets all these various constraints, whether it's a sector or currency constraints or country limits, again, you can drill down into every single section of the platform or any custom constraints, all you have to do is just save it and then optimize. Right now, the platform is looking for the alternative trades versus your current portfolio. And the objective is to generate extra return for the same level of risk. So let's give it a second. So now we have a 5.9% return for approximately the same risk parameters. which implies that we have increased our return by approximately 50 basis points, which in nominal terms on the portfolio of this size, it would imply around 2 million of additional return client can capture for the same level of risk. And all you have to do from here, if you are happy with the trade suggested, you just click on the transactions, you just review the trades, which are buys or sells, and then all you have to do is just click submit, and then the trading order is created and your trades are executed. So that's one product. Ultimately, if you want to pick up quickly a couple of basis points, which imply a couple of millions of incremental return, this is how you can use one product. And then the second product is credit assist. And I'm going to show just the one most important screen, which is the alpha generator. And what the alpha generator does, well, it scores multiple securities based on the multiple parameters. And those are then extrapolated into the future and used to suggest trades. So as we can see here, there is one selected security from UBS Group. We predict rating override. This is ultimately collaboration between the algorithm and user. We can predict spread, relative value scoring, it's another pricing information, industry news sentiment, liquidity scoring, company news sentiment, and credit risk. All these factors are feeding into the final score, which is 6.2022. And the objective of this score is ultimately tell the user how attractive particular security is. Anything which is 5 or above, we like. Anything which is 5 or below, we dislike. And if many people are asking us, you know, why should I trust it? This is just a black box model. Well, we are not saying that. What we are saying is that if you click on any particular security, you're going to get a pop-up which explains to you what's behind the trade idea. So it just explains to you what is the current security type. It then shows you key financial metrics for UBS, historic data, and also forward looking. It shows you financial ratios for that particular bank and also predictive power of each of those. It shows you relative value. So this is how security compares versus the similarly priced securities in the group and or alternative trades you can potentially implement. Then it shows you also the new sentiment. So you can read the most relevant stories and what is the new sentiment at the company and security level, and also show you the rating history. So you can see how the rating has been changing historically versus the current rating of a company. So that's the second functionality which I wanted to show. As I said, there is much more to show and to discuss, but I think the main message from here is if you want to capture incremental return, you can do it in 2 minutes versus 2 days or 2 weeks in the current world. And if you want your algorithms to monitor all the single holdings in your portfolio, you can do it through the multi-algorithmic model, which I have just presented. So that's us, Intellibonds. And if there are any questions, please go ahead. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Wow, very, very impressive. Very impressive show. When did you guys start your business?
We started our business back in 2018, but we have been really selling from 2022 because this is the incorporation. Then 1 year we were just asking for the data. Yeah. You know, the data for free doesn't come easily. So it took us a year to get the data. And then Moody's Analytics and IHS Markets helped us out back in 2019. And from 2020 to 2022, we have been building the products. And then we started commercially selling the product in summer 2022.
Okay, your customer list and your relationship list there, very, very impressive. A number of names that I, household names for sure. And then some other startups as well. Moody Analytics, IHS Market. I mean, these are all tremendous industry folks by way of data and analysis and collection as well.
Yeah, they have been very helpful. And we strongly believe in disruption through collaboration. So, you know, in our industry, because it's a B2B market and all the data sets are private, you have to collaborate in order to innovate. And yes, you do cause a disruption, but you cause it in a way where each of the incumbents which are in the market do benefit. that's the only way how you can, you know, move forward, because everybody looks for the win-win outcome.
Yeah. Solid team members, and again, high energy advisory board as well. How frequent does the advisory board meet?
Well, it's ad hoc. So, you know, whenever we need someone who has a business expertise, we just call up those people. I mean, all of them have very busy schedules. So honestly, just get every single one of them into a single room on a single day at the same time. It's close to impossible task.
I bet.
But normally what happens is, you know, there are some like Paul Hatfield or Mark Steiner who are more sort of involved on a weekly basis, you know, giving a couple of hours. Then there are gentlemen like Stan Beckers who, you know, once in a 3 months or 4 months, you know, just helps me out with something. So it's more kind of, you know, what help we need and what advice we need, and then we reach out to them.
The fact that you could actually review the information, you know, come up with, you know, put your parameters in, get a recommended kind of list, and then actually execute on it all kind of in, you know, seconds, if not a couple of, you know, certainly no more than a couple of minutes of looking, is pretty impressive as well. Mobile capable, Igor?
Sorry?
Mobile platform as well, or?
Yes, I mean, we are cloud native, so you can theoretically, you know, use it on mobile if you want, or you can use it on the PC, and you can do whatever you want from the perspective of access, because it deployed on Azure cloud. So, you know, any location, any user profile, any device you want to use, you can. What we do recommend for the most optimal experience, because there is like a lot of functionalities, PC would be preferred, mode of access, but you know, we don't limit. I mean, some people use tablets, some people use the phone. Depends what you want to do, because ultimately the more complex your workflow is, and the less of a patient you have for a small screen, let's put it this way.
And these are global fixed income securities, right? You're not just limited to US.
No. I mean, we currently have approximately 160,000 securities available. And of those are actively sort of managed, there are approximately 80,000, because there are like a lot of securities which are small and those don't trade. So we do have them as a passive addition in the list of securities, but people don't normally trade them. But about 80,000 are traded daily or at least weekly. So those are actively covered by ourselves, and whoever wants to add more, we can do, because as I said, we have about 160,000 securities available.
That's terrific. Two great platforms, Credit Assist and Portfolio Assist. And you said that it's a UK raise, $1 million, correct?
Yes, it's a UK raise. I mean, we do have some EU investors, so some Euro investors came in, and we have one American investor as well. So it's not necessarily just the UK. That said, because of the tax advantages investors have in the UK, we structured the initial round as a UK investment.
All right. Well, terrific. Well, great presentation. Thank you for the overview. The demo on both platforms there was terrific. And we wish you lots of luck here in the near term and going forward. Everybody, Igor Tesinsky from Intellibonds, thank you for your presentation today for One Startup World. Great work. Great job, and best of luck here in the future. Okay.
Thank you for having me, Glenn. Cheers.
Thank you very much. Take care. See you next time. Bye.